so much better. What is up, guys? So today is more like a tutorial slash like a tip deal. I'm going to show you a video that I created a couple months back. It was after I built my new computer and I was a little rusty. It didn't turn out quite the way I wanted it, but the client was happy, so that's cool. So in this video, I used a car clip and some blend modes to create a transition. And the car clip that I got was a complete accident. I had actually just still hit record on the camera. I was getting back in position on the one wheel. I was waiting for the talent to get back in position. And it turns out it was something that I didn't mean to get, but it was completely usable in the video. The tip is, don't scrub through all your footage and completely delete it without maybe working through the project a little bit and seeing if you could use it elsewhere. The tutorial is gonna start right now. Also, thanks mom for the coffee cup lens. Alright guys, so you can see this is my entire timeline from the video earlier that I just showed you. So we're going to concentrate on just the car clip and the transition that we made. So first I'm going to go up to File, New, and I need a new sequence so I can show you guys just those clips. I've already got them picked out and in a new bin. This is the car clip that I was talking about where I was on the one wheel and my talent was getting back into position. As you can see, like, there's really nothing to this clip. I think the reason that it stuck out to me was that the background was so like dull and brown and just like a warm kind of tone, and then you had this vibrant red car in the front. So I think that's, I don't know, I think that's why it stuck out to me in some way. I've already got this marked in and out with my markers. And I just want this section where the parachute opens up the entire, I guess it like expands it as big as it can get. I did not know I had a dog in my bed. Welcome to my life. So I'm just gonna grab the video, just the clip. I don't need all of it. Let's see, change sequence settings. Okay. So we're gonna go from him running, which is a pretty explosive, like high intensity clip, to him mixing this drink, which is what the product was. So again, I'm just gonna grab the clip. I'm gonna zoom in so you guys can see these. So right now, we've just got him running to him swirling this drink around. And I wanted to smooth that out a little bit with the transition. So like I said, we're gonna grab this car. This is the part that I chose earlier in the actual finished product of the video. I'm gonna grab that and lay it right in the middle. And if I play that back, you can see that it really doesn't match anything. And it looks pretty terrible. First thing I wanna do is left click, hit speed direction, and reverse the speed. That changes the direction that the car is going. And so now it's going from the back of the car to the front of the car, and for some reason I just feel like that matches the scene better. Next thing I need to do is, that is entirely too slow. And I know in the original clip of the speed I had already, it was 372. So I'm gonna just go back to the speed duration and type in 372. And then pull that back over the top of my clips, because you know, when I did that, it moved it. So that's a little bit quicker. I think I'm actually going to cut out some of this black car because I don't need all that. Shorten that up a little bit, turn it, put it back over the clips. That's what we're wanting. So if I play that back, you can see that kind of matches the speed of that run. The next thing I want to do is go back to the effects panels after clicking on your car clip, make sure that's selected, and look at some of these blend modes, because these blend modes, they do some really cool effects to after you're overlaying clips. Obviously some of them do nothing really. And I feel like blend modes are something people like maybe look over. I could be wrong, but I feel like people look over blend modes because it's so simple, and it's something like you want like to have all these effects, or like I want to throw fire, or I want to do like neon lines, or you know, these big attention grabbing effects, and you forget that sometimes the simplest ones are also just as cool. So that being said, I picked hard light. Oh, that's layering light. I picked hard light for this particular project because it still brought me that red contrast, and it still gave me those yellow tones in the background. So if I play that back now completely, that's looking a lot better, as like making an aesthetically pleasing transition. And that's all I'm actually going to show you today. In the final product, I added another overlay of like this vintage camera vibe. I think I added a flash right before it got to the drink. But that's it, man. I just wanted to show you guys something that you could do, and tell you guys that maybe take the next time, take an extra couple minutes and really scrub through your footage, and just maybe get into the creative process of actually making the video a little bit, and then go back into the footage that you thought was just wasteful, and just see if you can maybe turn it into something. Maybe you can, maybe you can't. Maybe you can save it for a different project later. If that was helpful in any way, I would appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel. I am trying to grow this channel and be like a real legit content creator. So that's what the goal is for right now. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out. Actually, not peace out. I'm back. So this weekend, wish me and my team luck. We're gonna go to Asheville, North Carolina, and we're gonna enter a short film competition. We have between Friday at 7:30 p.m. and Sunday at 7 or maybe 8 p.m. to storyboard, direct, edit, film the entirety of a short film we don't have. We have no clue what the genre is. We have no clue what characters we have to use. We have no clue what props we have to use. Literally, we find out everything on Friday, which is 2 days from now. That is what I'm hoping to make next week's vlog about, is my experience making a short film. It'll definitely come out. I'm hoping, like I said, next week it'll be that video. As much storyboard or storytelling as I've done has been really just a couple music videos. So this will be a completely new feel for me, a completely new feel for my team, film pilot with two other of my best friends in that company. This will be our first big project together. I'm super stoked about it. Wish us luck. I'll see you guys in the next video.